Yes, 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 yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Just trying to start off with a positive attitude.
Oh, yeah. I feel it.
Oh!
Hey, let me ask. It's running in my veins. I'm happy.
Let me ask you something. Do you have a problem with flies?
Oh, brother, let me tell you. I hate them flies.
I this is a serious question. There's one buzzing around me right now.
Oh.
I've got flies.
Well, just stick your tongue out and eat it.
Oh, I don't know why I didn't think of that. The old Garfield method. Or Kermit. I don't know. Maybe Garfield ate flies, too.
I think... I know my cat tries to get... Or my former cat, who now lives with my parents, tries to smash flies against the window. I don't know if she eats them or not.
I'm sorry to hear you and your cat broke up.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, it's been years. Water under the bridge.
But, I mean, into the arms of someone else.
I think of it more like she was my child, and I was like, I can't be bothered. And then
go live with your grandparents. I'm gonna go.
Yeah, it's probably
I gotta
like
go
a Jack
dance
Nicholson
on that pole
situation where she doesn't really remember me and she thinks that I'm her brother, but I'm really her dad.
Oh, Jack Nicholson. Whew.
Every time I go and visit my parents and she's there, like it takes a good 2 or 3 days before she gets used to me being there, but I only stay there for 2 or 3 days at the most. So she usually comes around and is like sitting in my lap and purring and everything. And I'm like, well, I'm going to go to another city now. See you later, cat.
I have kind of the opposite thing where the more I live with, well, they're my wife's pets. Sorry, I didn't mean to pause that long. I felt like I was going to hiccup.
Yeah, that's okay.
They aren't my wives. They're just dogs and cats.
My wives.
My wives.
You're marrying all of your pets.
That's my new. This is my new character, Polly Borat. My wives. God damn it. Stupid podcast.
And then I thought I missed something, and maybe you were talking about that movie about the talking bird.
Is there a movie about a talking bird?
Yeah, from the late 90s. Polly, P-A-U-L-I-E.
Oh,
I think it might have been voiced by Jay Moore. Wasn't bad as far as memory serves. I mean, you know, some birds can talk.
Yeah,
got
it seems
a lot
like
of talking dogs movies. They can't do that. There should be more talking birds movies.
I feel like that's
reality,
not...
Hollywood.
Yeah, it's a little. It's not fanciful enough that like the magical realism of the talking bird movie. It would be like if Air Bud was about a woman. No, there's nothing here that says a woman can't play basketball. I guess
it was more like this bird. Like people recognize the fact that this bird's probably going to talk, but. It wasn't him just doing calls. He had cognitive functions to actually speak to people. But only children would pay attention enough to be like, oh, yeah, this bird's not like the others.
The bird's like, listen, you got to listen to me. Pearl Harbor. The Japanese are coming.
False flag.
It's Tower 7. Look it up. They use nanothermite.
That's a smart bird.
I was going to say that I think that I have given off enough of a vibe that my wife's dog does not try to climb on my lap anymore. He just kind of is like, oh, this is the guy who doesn't like me.
Oh.
Which is not true. it made me feel special when the dog would try and climb up on my lap, but it's almost like he could understand the words that I was saying, and he was like, oh, well, if he thinks I'm a dickhead, I'll go sit on somebody else's lap.
Yeah. I usually do really well with animals, and in my mind, I'm like Snow White with a little chirping bird on my finger, or Cinderella, where they're, you know, doing up my tresses. But it is a huge downer when I meet somebody and their pet hates me.
Mm.
It's only happened a few times, but a little bit scarring. Like I had one friend who had a puppy that just, I was at his house for like 3 hours, and that dog spent the entire time, you know, like if he had digits, he would have been doing the cross in front of his face, like I was a vampire or something.
Oh, I thought you meant like snap.
Oh, no, no, no. It's
you don't
like,
know me.
you have, you know, we expect our animals to tip us off. Like they're supposed to see something. So
they see something, hey, they say something.
Stinky likes you. You must be good. But when Stinky's like shivering at your touch, you know, you feel like you're Demon Spawn. And I felt like Demon Spawn.
Yeah. So we did a really good job of keeping it positive here at the top of the show.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I feel like Demon Spawn.
I feel like Demon Spawn. I tried to do that to the tune of Chicken thing. Tonight. But.
Ooh. I like that song because it gets me excited for what my dinner is. I mean, I'm eating chicken every day anyway.
Yeah, there's.
Yeah, let's do chicken tonight.
That's one of my favorite genres of song, is the song that tells you what you're having for dinner. You got I Feel Like Chicken Tonight.
I remember the commercials for Beef, It's What's for Dinner, but they played Aaron Copland's Rodeo. When,
I know the tune.
Whichever way he pronounces it over top of it, and I'm like, yeah, it's manifest destiny that I'm going to have beef tonight.
Hey, we've got a segment here to do.
Okay.
It's the podcast hotline.
Let's play.
I'm all alone. Pick up the phone. Cat got your tongue. Pick up the phone.
Cat got your tongue.
Oh, it's the podcast hotline. Folks, if you have an idea for a podcast, or if you just want to say hello and leave a message, you can call that number. The number is 702-PODCASP. That's 702-PODCASP. We try to get podcast, but it wasn't available. So don't call that number. I don't know who it is. We got the next best thing. It's PODCASP, as in pickle. Anyways, here's our... We got a message on the podcast hotline here. I'm just gonna play it for us.
Hey, I was just calling to follow up on my idea for a cornhole podcast. I realized that the message cut out last time, and so I wanted to elaborate, make sure that we were all on the same page. So the idea is it's cornhole. But, huh? Okay, yeah. Uh-huh.
Oh, come on!
I gotta go.
Come on!
If you know, tell us the idea.
So, yeah,
is
thanks.
Is that the end of it? Oh,
yeah, God. That's where it ends, I guess.
Okay. All right. Let's wire up a cornhole board.
Are so blue. They're glowing like Dr. Manhattan.
What if we did a cornhole board where instead of one hole, it had like six holes and we rigged it up to a soundboard?
Oh, now this is an idea.
And you'd make a joke and you'd throw a cornhole bag and, you know, you're aiming for the soundboard punchline you want. You want a hey-o, but you might have hit a womp-womp.
Yeah, you're trying to punctuate your bits with a funny toilet flush noise, but instead you get a siren, and then a voice is like, "Turd police." You're like, "Oh, damn, well, I guess I..."
Oh, man.
Because we're throwing to turd police now.
And it does occur to me that I could probably poop into these holes and get a soundboard...
What if we just did a podcast just called Turd Police?
Acknowledgement of myself. Yeah, Turd Police. Pooping in holes.
Turd Police. Sewer
Born
Patrol.
Into this, pooping into holes. Sorry, we both did it at the same time. Sewer Patrol?
That was my, yeah. Or maybe Sewer Police. Turd Patrol.
Oh, man. We can deputize alligators.
Yeah.
And put a cop hat on them.
But
we're gonna have to do like a chin strap for them, because when they go underwater, I don't want it to fall off of their big scaly heads.
Yeah, maybe we team up an alligator and a crocodile. It's a buddy cop movie.
Oh yeah,
Sewer Police.
Which offensive accent are we going to give the crocodile? Are we going to go with an African accent or an Australian one?
Oh, I think...
I mean, we it's one or the other, right?
Yeah, I think it's going to be Cajun alligator and an Australian crocodile. And then
okay.
It's just no one can understand the movie at all. It's just going to...
Oh, well, they're going to be underwater a lot of times, so it's just going to be a lot of bubbles.
We're going to go catch that old bird boy. We're going to get him. We're going to get him in the jail, and yeah, going to catch a big guy. Yeah, we're going to catch a big guy. We're going to throw him down to y'all.
Turd police.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, caller, for your idea.
I love that idea.
Turd police. Sewer justice. Man, that's a dinger. That I thought for sure that this would be called Polly Borat, but now maybe Turd Police Sewer Justice might have just bumped it.
We're early on too. I mean, there's so much still to come. Everybody.
So far, all we've generated is a couple of good episode name ideas and nothing else.
Well, do you want a podcast idea?
Give me an idea. Give me a true, real. I need that good shit.
Okay. Well, because the podcast phone line has just generated such a good idea, I think we should use it for a podcast proper. Voicemails to the editor is my idea. We come up with some sort of burning question that all Americans have an opinion on, and set that question up on the podcast phone line and have people call in. And then we, I guess, debate canned phone calls.
So you know, want...
From a place of power where we can listen to them beforehand. And
I mean, listen, we're always in a place of power. Don't get it twisted.
My throne may squeak, but that does not make it not a throne.
It squeaks because it's made out of a million rats.
Well, they tied themselves together with their tails.
I'm the king. I'm the king of the turd police. I sit upon a throne of rats, doling out sewer justice.
I do want that Willard power, you know.
Willard Scott,
might
the power to be Ronald McDonald. Just going around wishing people a happy 100th birthday.
I already have that power. But they're usually mad at me because they're usually much younger than 100. And I say, hold on to it.
happy 100th birthday.
Put that in your back pocket until you become 100 years old, and then take it back out and treasure it and be like, oh, I remember when AJ gave me this birthday greeting. I was a, you know, just a lad.
It's like the end of The Usual Suspects. They're like, they realize that you wished them a happy 100th birthday like 30 years ago. You know, and they drop, they're in the middle of making breakfast and they just drop. It shows it smashing on the floor, just strawberry preserves going everywhere. And then Willard Scott, with a name like Smuckers, it has to be good. Brought it all around.
You can wish anyone a happy 100th birthday, but if they actually get to 100, they'll probably remember you. If they die before that, who cares about them? I mean,
we don't have a podcast challenge for the week, folks. If you're out and you see an older person, you say, "Hey, happy 100th birthday!" And then when they say, "It's not my 100th birthday," yeah, but I'm not gonna be around then, so I just wanted to get it in now. And then when you die before them, their mind will be blown. And if they die before you, you know, they're not going to care. You've gamed the system.
Easy come, easy go, you know.
Will you let me go?
You aren't going to get 100% of these birthday wishes right.
But the people you get wrong.
One out of 365 about the birthday in the first place.
You're going to get zero complaints on wrong answers on this one. It has a 100% rate of return. And
if you're always carrying a small little plate with a piece of cake around on it, I don't think anybody's going to care that much. If you give them cake, that you can stuff a lot of bad bullshit down your throat if it's got a cake sandwich around it.
Now I want to get back to the idea of people calling in. So they're just going to call in.
So we would pose some sort of question or put forth a topic. Hmm.
And then people maybe call in and we discuss their answers or their contributions.
And where appropriate, debate them.
Yeah, I like this because they can't fire back. No rebuttals. They call in, they say,
they better be coming with fire.
I think the Godfather 2 is the best. And then we're like, wrong, it's Godfather 3. And they can't do a goddamn thing about it. They'll call back next week. We've changed the number.
See, the first two Godfathers are
we're like, Michael Corleone don't live here no more.
Back to the Future 1 did? But Godfather 3 does what Back to the Future 2 and 3 did, because Michael, what about your kids?
Yeah.
And that's why it's better. It's a bigger story. It's like the whole family gets to join the reunion.
Also, ZZ Top cameo. Everybody loves that. When they go to meet with the mob in Italy, La Cosa Nostra, and then it's Billy Gibbons rolls up in the Eliminator. How? How are you treating me like this?
I think that ZZ Top at some point should have put a jazz album out just so it could be just ZZ Top.
You're right about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like the idea of using the podcast hotline to
We can't really run through a dry take of it though, because we have to have outside input on it, but I don't know. We got this new toy. Let's take it for a whirl.
Yeah. We're like everyone's uncle with their new drone quadcopter.
Yeah.
Just wanting to fly it around the house, banging into stuff. All right. All right. Here's my idea for a podcast. This I wrote down, make Dare cool.
Now I'm guessing you're talking about the anti-drug organization Dare, because dares are always cool. I dare you to jump off your house right now.
Yeah, that is cool.
Do it.
Okay.
Go and climb up on your roof and jump off.
All right. I'll be right back. And then I'm just going to edit in the sound of me. It's just going to be like some wacky sound effects. Woo. All right. Ah, there we go.
All right. See, that was cool.
It was so cool. Everyone in the neighborhood said it was cool.
But you're talking about like... trying to teach people that drugs are bad and then reward them at the end of a year of choking down your propaganda by giving them a rock band composed of uniformed policemen.
Wait, what was your experience with Dare like? You had a cop band to play for you?
Yes.
I think that you might be an outlier here. I've never
Is
heard
that
anyone.
Not what happens?
I've never, that was not my experience with Dare. It sounds like yours was cool.
Wait, I'm trying to remember. We did Just Say No and Dare. And maybe the cop band was for Just Say No. But we went to the local community center, convention center thing. And they had games and stuff. But the highlight was they all set us up. We had folding chairs in front of a stage, and then there was a rock and roll band where every member of the rock and roll band was wearing a police uniform, and then they sang a bunch of songs that were some classic rock covers, but also some original songs about how drugs are bad.
What? This is incredible.
And,
this is
all
not
the girls, you know, screamed so loud. I couldn't even hear how beautiful the music that they were playing was. So my experience was ruined by how sexy those hot cops were.
They it's a constant problem, you know, teenage girls just being crazy about middle-aged cops.
I wish they told me to bring some earplugs. And like those... that's the thing. Like you go to a metal show or you go to a punk show. Now you know to bring those little foam things, but you aren't expecting that when you're 9 years old and you're just going on a field trip.
Just going on a field trip to see some off-duty cops playing Black Dog.
Are there any drugs that stop ear bleeding?
Yeah, so it sounds like you have a pretty good idea of how to make Dare cool.
It needs to be a different kind of cool. There was a very strong appeal. I mean, you put all your burliest cops in uniform and give them an axe to grind and maybe some skins to pummel and... You know, you play Mustang Sally for the kids, and they're gonna love it.
So, what are some other kinds of cool that we could make? I immediately just want to think of like maybe we get Greta Gerwig in here to do a pass at Dare, see what she brings to the table.
That's a cool thought.
She's very cool, but also she seems grounded, you know, in a way that I think most people who are writing curriculum for Dare aren't.
Mm-hmm. I remember she was in that Arthur movie with what's his name?
Arthur?
The remake of Arthur.
They remade
no,
it?
No.
Is he not an aardvark this time?
No, the Dudley Moore movie Arthur. They remade that.
I know. I'm being a fool.
Oh, okay. I mean,
New York City. I know what Arthur is.
Yeah. But when she remade that, I mean, she why can I not think of that guy's name? Can you please help me out? Arthur
Cobblepot.
Yeah, Arthur Cobblepot. Yeah. He was the Penguin's brother. He's like the skinny, cool Penguin.
The Puffin.
Yeah. Yeah. Everybody wants to fuck the Puffin. Nobody wants to fuck the Penguin.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about. The guy that... yeah.
Brand.
Russell Brand.
Russell Brand.
I wanted to say Jesus Christ, but that wasn't.
But anyway, she dealt with Russell Brand, as far as I know, still in the throes of his addiction cycle. So she probably has some pretty strong insights. And she remained pleasant and probably the best part of that movie throughout. So I think that she'd be a strong addition to our new cool dare.
Yeah. You know, they had great for the gangs and dare for the drugs, but they didn't really have, like a proper one for like sex. That's what failed me. That's how the American education system didn't tell me how to use my dick.
I think that's just generally a big problem with people not wanting proper sex education. I think that's how we make it cooler, is we just teach people honestly about sex.
Well, maybe that's the podcast. Maybe it's dare, but the way we make it cool is it's sex instead of drugs.
We're still going to take the mindset about against drugs, but then we're going to give like a Dr. Ruth-esque proper accounting of sexual activity for the kids.
This is how you do dare the right way. You don't talk about drugs at all. Instead, you're like, hey, let me tell you about how much fun fucking is. And then everybody just forgets all about drugs, and they're like, I'm looking to get my dick wet.
But we live in a country where they're trying very hard to criminalize safe sex. I mean,
they hate the fucking, they hate the sucking.
We have like one Planned Parenthood left open.
They want them unplanned. That's secretly the governors, all of those guys, they defund Planned Parenthood because they just love thinking about all those people raw dogging.
Yeah. Well, P.T. Barnum once said there's a sucker born every minute. And he didn't have to deal with Planned Parenthood. So I think they're trying to maintain that sucker born every minute statistic. We don't want to fall below a half a sucker born every minute threshold, because then there aren't going to be any suckers left.
If we could just teach these kids to be sucking every minute.
Yeah, maybe less
pregnancies, less unwanted
drugs. Yeah, more sucking.
More sucking, less fucking. Welcome to Cool Dare. Today, we're talking about butt stuff. That's right. There's no babies in that butt. You can't knock one loose like you can in the lady's pee hole.
I know a lot of people on the playground are talking about butt babies, but that's euphemistic. You don't actually have a little turd brother. Like, that's not going to happen.
Yeah. Listen, butt babies were part of the Ninja Turtle craze of the early 90s. You had the Street Sharks, the Battle Toads, the Butt Babies. Do you have an idea for a podcast?
Yeah, but I do want to point out that even though we all call them Butt Babies, their proper name was Cabbage Patch Kids.
It's true.
Yeah, I got another podcast idea. This
you
one
know, on Punky Brewster, they called them Butter Lettuce Babies. All right, sorry. Butter, go ahead.
This is Not Without Knots. And it's going to be a filmic podcast where we analyze a film. But think about how it would be different if great American actor Don Knotts was the protagonist and not some other not as good person. So instead of let me think about this. If Robert De Niro weren't in Taxi Driver, but Don Knotts were in Taxi Driver, how would that change that film and the message? You know, instead of an angry speech into a mirror, it would be like a self-conscious one. We're like, are you looking at me? Huh?
How's this grab you? What if on Not Without Knots, we discussed our new idea for a film, Not Without Knots, and it's Sally Field trying to sneak out of Iran with Don Knotts. But it's Don Knotts playing a baby like the like Little Man, that Wayans Brothers movie where Marlon Wayans?
Yeah. I think it was Marlon was the baby.
It was just a Bugs Bunny movie.
Sean's always the straight man.
It's true. But it was just the plot of that old Bugs Bunny cartoon, right? Where the mobster looks like a baby and they like disguise him as a baby to hide from the police.
I never actually watched Little Man because when I watched the trailer for Little Man, it made my skin crawl.
Oh.
And then I had like a weird period where I was like, this isn't a racist thing, right? This is a bad special effects thing.
I hate babies.
Because I also hated white chicks. Like it also...
I mean...
And it might have...
There's something uncanny about the movie White Chicks.
There was definitely something uncanny about Marlon Wayans playing a baby, too. But sometimes I like that. Like, I liked when Martin Short was in Clifford and he played a 9-year-old for an entire movie. I was totally down for that, but they didn't morph his... use computer technology to morph his body in any way.
It's wild that they use that technology to make that Little Man movie, huh?
I mean, I get it. I'm surprised there hasn't been more of it. Frank, I mean, we also had the Rock. His first big role was the Scorpion King, and he was like a terrible CG scorpion monster with the Rock's face plastered on it.
See, I don't think the Rock's face was superimposed. That looked like a video game character. Like, that was just a bad CGI model of the Rock. Not video of the Rock, but then his face was squished onto...
It was bad in a different way than Little Man was. I mean, but you gotta have your Little Mans to get the technology right. Somebody's gotta make the Little Mans. So that we can get the Rock to play the big man later on. And you're like, whoa, look how big the Rock is. I always thought he was big, but he's like 3 times as big as he used to be.
He's getting bigger all the time. You can't deny that. He's huge.
18-foot tall Rock walking down the street. only going to the big restaurants and the, you know, the big stores, the ones that got the tall doors.
He's just
go to medieval times and shit like that, but ooh.
He's over in Jurassic Park. He's just slamming that giant gate every time he gets mad about something. God.
If Jurassic World isn't angling itself towards getting a 15 to 18 foot tall The Rock fighting whatever T-Rex composite monstrosity that they've been, you know,
they got,
that's,
they're like, listen, they we're playing God now. We're tweaking all this DNA. Listen, we made the Imperius Rex. He's the even bigger, worse dinosaur. We also, we made a raucous magnificent.
Attitudinous rock.
Petrus attitudinous. It's the rock, the attitude era rock. But he's 70 feet tall and he fights the other dinosaurs. He's such a showman.
The dinosaur's elbow.
Oh, that would be a hell of a film.
But we also have to make sure that Don Knotts is in it.
Don Knotts is in it. Yeah.
I think he'd probably be fulfilling the Wayne Knight role. I could see Don Knotts taking like a darker turn and possibly wanting to bring the giant The Rock to America to ruin the little teeny tiny The Rock's reputation.
So The Rock,
I mean, who's going to want to put The Rock in a movie? Yeah, yeah. Like they stole his DNA from like a water bottle or something, mm-hmm. and made an 18-foot one. And Don Knotts is just trying to do the plot from King Kong and bring that rock on a boat back to New York City. He can just be held in chains at Radio City Music Hall for us all to enjoy.
See, this is a wild deviation from where I thought this idea would go, because Don Knotts clearly is the scientist in the movie who's saying, we can't play God, we gotta nip it in the bud. But I like the idea of him being, this is a departure for Knotts. People, that's what they say in Entertainment Weekly. The new Jurassic Park film, a huge departure for both Dwayne The Rock Johnson and Don Knotts back from the grave.
Well, I mean, you can't make up like a super mega, we're going to cross all this animal DNA together movie without both The Rock and Don Knotts. Maybe this should be not without Knotts and The Rock.
I think that we
have a hypothetical buddy team here.
Knotts rocks. Rock Knotts. Rock Knotts.
Like when
that sounds like
those
a
bread knots from the pizza place, and forget about them for a couple of days. They're now Rock Knotts.
I see. I thought Rock Knotts sounds like a failed like a toy line from the 80s, and these were like guys who drive little drilling machines down into the earth.
Or maybe it's Knotts like N-A-U-T-S.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. They're Rock Knotts.
Oh, I was thinking they were like astronauts, but they have a guitar or they play the drums.
Oh, they're Rock Knotts. Now that you guys have finished your semester of DARE, give it up for the Rock Knotts.
We're not going to do drugs in space either. Because, you know, you got to respect space.
Now give it up for, we only play covers of songs from bands that didn't do the drugs. Here's the Osmond Brothers, Crazy Horses. Crazy horses, wee, wee. Crazy Horses does slap. If you don't know Look up Crazy Horses. It is the Donny Osmond and his brother's psychedelic rock band. They're Mormon psychedelic rock band, and that song Crazy Horses
is the band called Crazy Horses?
No, I think they're called the Osmond Brothers, but
okay.
They put out an album called Crazy Horses, and there's a title track, Crazy Horses.
Because I was going to say, like, almost all of my favorite Neil Young is Crazy Horse, the band. That is your prog Young.
Yeah.
I think there's some 80s Neil Young that's pretty prog, too, that... But that's good too.
Yeah. And of course, now that you can't call it Crazy Horse because that's not politically correct.
It's not.
Neurodivergent horse. They've ruined another thing.
Why do people have feelings? Should just have preference or you know, just be fans of stuff. Don't ever be mad about anything. Haven't you learned that your feelings aren't valid in this culture? God damn.
Not without knots.
Not without knots. Never again.
All right. All right, here's my next idea. This is called What's in a Baby Name? Yesterday, Today, and Forever. So this would be a podcast where we talk about baby names, but we cover the whole gamut. The past, the present, and the future of baby names.
Okay. And also possibly like if you name your baby Little Cute Schnookums, we could look like in the present, yes, a very, very little cute Schnookums. But during grade school times, not so good. And it's going to take a really weird, strong pivot to make that work as an adult.
Yeah, Little Cute Schnookums pleads no contest to seven counts of murder in the third degree.
Yeah, that was his pivot, murdering.
Little Cute Schnookums.
Stealing enough money to hire a lawyer to get him off.
Yeah. Little Cute Schnookums ejected from Major League Soccer after footage of him exposing himself in a Tesco goes viral.
Oh, this is a little cute British baby.
Yeah, Little Cute Schnookums, and he's a perverse soccer
hooligan.
Well, no, he's not a hooligan. He played. He was on Manchester, but he kept exposing his dick to old ladies.
It's the Tesco. So easy. I mean, you pull that little lip of your soccer shorts down. I mean, doesn't take. There's no loosening of a belt and an unbuttoning and an unzipping. It's just a blip.
What are you Schnookum's lawyer all of a sudden?
I'm just saying.
Let he who is not.
I don't think this
himself...
was premeditated. I mean the lip of his pant is so easily brought down,
folks,
that anyone might have accidentally, purposefully. There was no time at all for him to reconsider his flashing.
Folks, now my opponent would have you believe that his friend here exposed his penis and balls accidentally. But if you agree, please call 702 Podcast and let us know. See, I tied that back in with the...
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's some good branding. I'm proud of you. Oh, I don't know. I don't want to defend my client anymore because he's a ball-bearing bastard. And he deserves the kick in the balls that the government has planned for him. And the Patron does, too. Patron is, you know, rearing up its robotic leg for that classic, you know, kick in the gum there.
A ball-bearing bastard. Oh, I didn't mean to cut you off in the middle of that. It was a good rant.
That's all right.
All right. Well, let's go to the Podtron. And you heard it. It jumped the gun a bit there.
Folks, my client,
Podtron 4500 is a simple added machine. We've given it the names of the top 200 podcasts on the Apple Podcast. And now I'll defer to my crocodile partner. That's right. Now we're going to go to the Podtron. All right. So,
okay.
Podtron's got a list of ideas for podcasts based on the top rated podcasts on iTunes or Apple Podcasts. They've split into two different apps now. This first one is called "Stay, I Hear the Doctors."
Okay, so I'm guessing this is going to be a podcast where we bug hospitals and just listen in on bad news being broken.
Stay, I hear the doctors. It makes me think like the doctors are after me and I'm calling 911 and the dispatcher is trying to hang up and I'm like, no, stay, I hear the doctors. They're in the other room. They're searching for me. It's Joseph Mengele.
I've only heard like I've spent 3 hours in this hospital room, and I'm trying to extricate myself, and the person who's in the hospital is saying like, "Oh no! Like it's gonna happen soon. We're gonna find something out. we're gonna find out what my prognosis is."
Oh, so yeah, it's. It's stay until I hear the doctors.
Well, yeah, it's probably the dying person being like, I'm pretending to hear the doctors. So, like, maybe we should do something where somebody's actually hearing the doctors. That's probably better.
Okay. I mean,
would in your idea, what do you think the doctors were going to do? Do you think the doctors were going to take them away? We got to stop the doctors?
Oh, maybe they are. Maybe they're like funny farm doctors.
Yeah. Or Trump doctors. Maybe they're going to give them another Clorox injection and they wouldn't.
It's just that the guy with the gray ponytail just tells everyone that they're in excellent health.
As long as you keep eating your Kellogg's cornflakes, all of your dirty mind thoughts will be cured. And you're like, I wanted to cure my cancer.
That's, yeah. So that's Stay, I Hear the Doctors.
Sorry, I ruined that one.
I think it came pre-ruined, to be fair.
Yeah, we should have done Fun Doctors. I are there Fun Doctors?
There's Dr. Feelgood.
Yeah, we should have done, like, should have tied that into the dare idea.
I mean, we still could.
Making doctors fun again. With dare. In space. With Don Knotts.
There we go. And he's naming babies.
Yeah. And number 7 on the Podtron list, the Dan twins. They're here too.
The Dan twins.
which I think we would just pick two Dans, decide that they're twins for the day anyway, and just see how being a Dan is. See how the other side lives, you know? Us non-Dans and the Dans, the Dan twins.
Yeah. We could be the Dan twins.
We could, but we'd have to be Dan for a day. And I would have to, that day, wake up and be like, today I am Dan.
Dan twin.
And
sounds
and
like the
that,
name.
That
of
would be a great thing, because immediately I would think, Dan's the man, and that's who I am.
Oh, shit. Now you're rhyming.
Yeah. I mean, they're like a Dr. Seuss-esque book would definitely come out of us doing the Dan twins.
Sorry. Ugh.
Oh, my goodness. Ugh. Do you lose any part of your proper insides on that one?
No, just the improper insides.
Okay, good.
it's a case for the turd police. All right, I got one here.
Okay.
This is the Podtron. It's a number 97 on the Podtron list. WTF with Breakfastards. It's a portmanteau of breakfast and bastards. And I love that.
I'm definitely a breakfast bastard.
I think we're both breakfast bastards.
I love that breakfast food, and I'm a bastard. So, breakfastard.
So,
breakfastard?
Breakfastards?
I don't like that as much.
Breakfastards?
That makes me think about Uncle Fester.
I think it's breakfastards.
Yeah, I think that makes me think like I'm going to be moving more quickly. I'm going to... A breakfastard is someone who's ready to meet the day. A breakfastard is a guy wearing his Uncle Fester cosplay and sitting on his couch and never greeting the day. So I like your pronunciation.
Now I kind of want to both of us go through extensive bald cap makeup and just go to Denny's and record it from a Denny's. Everyone's social distancing. We're both putting light bulbs in our mouths.
Tons of pancake makeup. I don't know how we're going to get those light bulbs to turn on. Was there some sort of do I have to put part of the machinery in my mouth and pancake over the wire going down my pants to the battery pack on my belt?
Yeah, we request a booth with an outlet. And then we come in ahead of time, you know, and
we're going to have to get there early, and then they're going to be drunk people who are mad they can't charge their iPhones because of us.
You should have thought of that before you tangled with the breakfast bastards.
the breakfasters.
We need to come up with what WTF stands for in this, because it can't be what the fuck. That's already a podcast. This is...
Waffles and toast are our food, but I mean, that's kind of other...
waffle toast.
I think waffles, waffle toast,
Fastards. It stands for We the Fastards with the Breakfastards.
Yeah, that sounds like a pretty good breakfast anyway.
It's
if that one doesn't work, I would enjoy.
It's us, and we're just a couple of breakfast bastards discussing the Declaration of Independence. We the Fastards with breakfast.
Okay. And
this is part of a larger universe of fastered related content.
I'm denying the bastard portion of this.
It's annoying.
Denying.
You know, I was stationed in denying.
Oh my god. I just love the idea of a war movie where there are no proper sound effects. There's only silly sound effects for all the explosions. Boings and wheeze and
owie. Maybe we just do that. Instead of a podcast, we just release a Full Metal Jacket, but with us going pew 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 instead of the fully.
I think that's a pretty good idea. I would like to provide alternate non-verbal soundtracks for action movies. That would be
oof.
I mean, that's not a podcast, but that is an alternate line of compensation for us that we should get on.
Mm-hmm. We should, you know what? Have you ever done this where you accidentally put on the dialogue for the visually impaired mm-hmm. on your TV? Yeah. And then it's like a globe spins, the word universal. Like, it just immediately starts describing the movie when you turn it on, and you're like, what the hell is this? Maybe we should just do that. Just do like a movie where we describe what's going on.
And then anytime that movie gets picked up by any sort of streaming service, just offer gratis so people get used to it.
Yeah.
And then want it, and then they start paying us.
All right. Do you got another one?
Yeah, this one is number 28. It is S-Town.
S-Town is a real podcast.
Oh, shit. All right. Well, then I'll do number 24. Dirty Did Tiny Me.
Dirty Did Tiny Me?
Yeah.
Do you have an idea of what that would be?
Originally, I was thinking that Dirty was a reference to the old Dirty Bastard. And I was just thinking about like any time that there is a character that uses the Alvin and the Chipmunks style speed up.
Dirty Did
vocalization. So I think that replacing sped up vocalizations in movies with past old Dirty Bastard slash Dirt McGirt, you know,
Big Baby Jesus.
Anything done by that fellow, we can take every word that he's ever said, like the film critics from the Chicago Tribune did with Roger Ebert, and create a mouse version of Old Dirty Bastard that can do tiny versions of cartoon characters.
Hmm. Wow. I can't believe I'm saying this, but I think you've come up with the worst idea for a podcast of all time.
It stood out to me as a title, and I did not think it should be a podcast, but I wanted to talk about, think about those gravelly tones being slowed on down, and now it's fival.
Now that's what I call fival.
Maybe we got an old Dirty Mickey Mouse, you know, any
old Dirty Mousetard. Old Dirty Fastard, and he likes breakfast.
Yeah, we maybe blend that together.
It's a real bastard centric episode, huh?
Yeah, and now I'm starting to think about how you know how if you watch anime for kids, it's okay for them to just be like, bastard! Like, they'll just shout it at people all the time.
Well, you know, like all these kids watching that, they're bastards, so.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Bastard! What? No, bastard.
I'll take you to hell, bastard! Like, they're so into it.
Yeah.
I can't, I, oh, like, I,
it's confusing because all these kids, they're faithfully. Like, are you talking to me? No, honey, there's a lot of kids named Bastard. See, Dare never taught us to use rubbers, so your whole generation, they're all bastards. We were steering clear of drugs, but we were getting busted in.
Yeah, we had to find some sort of solace, and that solace saddled us with you.
All right, I got another one here.
Named you Bastard.
We named you Bastard. It's a family.
You got another
name.
One?
Yes, yeah, I do. And it's called Snacks Daily.
Snacks Daily?
Snacks Daily.
That's how I take them.
That is.
You know.
Yeah.
I don't do snacks weekly or snacks monthly. It's just not the way to stay happy.
But listen, if you're a snacks delivery box company and you want to sponsor our podcast, we will gladly go to snacks weekly or monthly.
Or, you know, it might be best for you if the people buy in and they need their snacks daily.
Snacks daily. That's right.
Just like a one of those small envelope slips. Like we're going to send you your daily snacks every single day.
This is the one we should do.
You're going to open it up. You got a pack of fruit snacks in there. You got a granola bar. You got because it's so fresh and so quick. You got a some sort of yogurt choice. We have yogurt choices.
And this could be an entire hour of branded content where we just discuss the snacks that are offered by our sponsor, Snacks Daily. And it's a guy named Daily.
Oh, yeah. Snacks has the best snacks. I mean, his parents named him appropriately because Snacks.
Hi, I'm Snacks Daily. And,
good to have you here, Snacks.
I just wanted to thank everybody for signing up for my new Snacks Daily mailing list, where I mail everybody a snack every day. I got some good ones coming up.
I heard when you were but a boy that the only snacks were peanuts. Is that true?
That's true. We only had peanuts, once in a while, me and my friends, we'd sneak down to the old Egyptian theater, and there was a hole drilled in the wall by some of the old newspaper boys, and you could put your eye up to it, and you could see, we'd sneak a peek of Jordan almonds. They had them in there. Behind the refreshment table. They weren't available back in those days.
Yeah.
It was a kind of a, you had to know who to talk to get a peek at the Jordan almonds.
How do you feel about the Raisinets?
Well, you know, back in my day, the Raisinets were were only allowed to play at certain theaters, if you know what I mean. But, eventually, what Captain Kirk kissed Lieutenant Uhura, and then the Raisinets were everywhere.
You could dump them in your popcorn and whatnot.
Oh boy, we used to dump everything in the popcorn. That's how I got my first wife pregnant.
You put a hole in the bottom of the popcorn barrel, and then
she was a pretty large woman. She sat down, got mixed up, sat in the wrong seat, and landed right on the popcorn bucket. And well, I was in the process of dumping into the popcorn, ended up ended up going home with her and you know, getting married. And
yeah, it's not something that's uncommon.
Oh, in those days, it was
pretty common. It was a thing that happened.
They'd say he's a son of Charlie Chaplin. They'd say that meant
they said that about a.
You accidentally did a large woman fell onto your erect member, and you ejaculated inside her in a darkened theater on accident, and then had to go home and be married to her for the first 13 years of your life.
Or sometimes a zoo animal on accident, if you were a zookeeper.
Oh, I was married to about 6 different zoo animals.
Luckily, they don't live as long as us. So,
it's true. Yeah,
you just gotta put in your time. Wait for that elk to die.
It's true. Yeah, no, I was married. Yeah, ironically, I was once married to a black widow.
Ooh, you got a lot of kids then. That egg sack. Oh boy.
Oh yeah. No. To clarify, it was Florida Evans from Good Times. She just said, damn, damn, damn. I think this bit's gone on too long.
Yeah.
All right, I'll see you later.
There's no Don Knotts in it, so it's probably over.
Well, you know, I think it's possibly a good idea, but nobody can do a good Don Knotts, so I showed up instead.
Well, Snacks do you have Daily. Any idea? Yeah, Snacks Daily. It's a pretty good one. Like one. Do you know which one of these ideas you want to do next week?
We're running down. We had Turd Police Sewer Patrol. Voicemails to the editor. Make Dare Cool, Not Without Knots, We the Fastards with Breakfastards, Dirty Did Tiny Me, and Snacks Daily. I think that it's probably going to be kind of a mishmash of a couple of these, but do you have any thoughts?
There's nothing that doesn't seem hard. did you say what was the voicemail? That is
voicemails to the editor.
If I think that could be a strong show, but we can't pick the branding elsewhere. We can't put other stuff into it unless we put some sort of question on the voicemail that people are supposed to answer.
I think we should do a breakfast one. People feel strongly about their breakfasts.
Okay.
We could make it a voicemail breakfast thing called the Breakfastards.
Okay.
And it's Let's us do a taking calls, podcast. Talking about breakfast. All right, folks, if you want to hear We the Fastards with Breakfastards, that's going to be on our Patreon. That's patreon.com/ we don't have a podcast yet. You can listen to it there. If you want to call in with a breakfast idea or a breakfast opinion that you want to hear discussed, that's going to be at 702 podcast. That's 702 PODCASP. Leave your message there for us, and we the Breakfastards will discuss it. Other than that, go to our website, www.smalldictionary.com. There you can leave us a review. Give us
we are coming up with small definitions for as many small words as we can.
Yeah, we're very small men. We have small definitions at smalldictionary.com. Other than that, thank you for listening. Tell your friends about the show. And we'll see you next week. All right, goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Oh, don't you, don't you.